Before you leave your home, do you inspect yourself in the mirror to ensure that your clothes fit you properly? Have you seen other people on their daily business and thought, why haven't your friends told you how ridiculous you look? And are you a victim of the wrong bra syndrome? All these questions and more will be answered on tonight's The Law Factor Live.
The views expressed in this program are those of the host and guests and in no way represent those of DBS, and are not intended to determine decision-making processes. Dolaw Factor Live is produced by Delia Dolaw Productions and Consultancy and sponsored by EC Global Insurance, Court St. Lucia, Infinity Color Shop, Ference Dairy, Star Publishing, Transit TV, Paradise Water, Prestige Auto Holdings, Sea Island Cutting Shop.
Welcome to The Law Factor Live. I'm Delia Dolaw. Our theme tonight is keeping up appearances, which means we're going to discuss how to dress appropriately for the occasion and highlight some of the fashion mishaps we see frequently. Before I introduce tonight's guest, I'd like to extend sympathies to one of The Law Factor Live's previous special guests, Senator Berthia Pahl, who recently sent off her husband Johnny Pahl in a wonderful and memorable way. Thank you to the Destang family for all the obvious help, support and love they gave to Berthia and Johnny's families. Also, I'd like to acknowledge the passing of fashion designer and personality Kingsley Thorne from Barbados, and he too will be sorely missed. But as I'm sure Berthia and Kingsley would tell me, the show must go on. And so my guests tonight are Vanessa Phillips of Models Magnifique Training School and Kishelle Maidard of Sea Island Cotton Shop. Good night, ladies.
Good night.
Welcome to the The Law Factor Live set.
Thank you.
I know we're going to have a good time tonight, because anytime we talk about fashion and hair and clothing and all those kind of things, there are things that come up that you just think, well, people should know this, but they just keep on doing this, you know?
Exactly.
So I'm really looking forward to showing our viewers some of the examples of how they dress and how perhaps they should consider dressing. All right, so we're ready for the show tonight?
Oh, yes, we are.
good. Well, you've actually had your Ference ice cream, so you should be nice and relaxed.
Yeah.
Okay, do you know what flavors you tasted tonight? Yeah, I know we had the rum and raisin, something like you don't know.
Yeah, we had the rum and raisin.
And the other one we had?
I think there was a bit of coconut in the one I had.
That's right, coconut, definitely. And I'm sure that you both enjoy your Ference ice cream, right?
Yeah. Oh, yes, it's good, very good. Tasty.
Right, so we're now calm, we're collected, and we're ready to kind of discuss what's happening. Mm-hmm. How was your week so far, both of you? Vanessa?
Very, very busy, but it comes with the territory.
Mm-hmm.
But I enjoyed it. I enjoy being busy. Mm-hmm. I don't like being, you know, okay, what am I going to do today?
Mm-hmm.
So my entire week has been packed.
Okay.
Yeah.
Lovely. Mm-hmm. And for you, Kishelle?
Well, it's been very busy for us at Sea Island. I've been trying to coordinate our back-to-school promotion, and with all the kids going back to school soon, we're trying to, like, wrap this up at the end of the week.
Mm-hmm.
So for the past 2 weeks, it has been very exciting, but a very busy period.
And I know you had a bag on Facebook that you were like, it was everywhere, this bag. have you chosen the winner yet?
Well, the winner, we choose that winner tomorrow evening. We'll be announcing it on our Facebook page and on Radio Caribbean International with DJ Pringles.
Is there enough time for people to join in?
Yeah, they
tonight?
Can still, yeah, okay. Yeah, because it was supposed to have ended last week Friday, but we extended that deadline just because we're getting so many responses. So we said, why not give them an extra week?
Mm-hmm.
So they have up till tomorrow at 4:30 to put in your answers in. Why should you win that Kipling bag to go back to school?
Well, I have to say, and I hope some people don't get annoyed with me for saying, people have approached me and say, Dean, if you get me that bag, I'll give you something. So they're smart. They're not offering me money, but they're offering me something that they have.
Something.
So it's out of my control.
Yeah.
You know, it has nothing to do with me. It's my sponsor, you know? So yeah. I know a lot of people want that.
Yeah, and the great thing about it is you could choose from 3 bags. So we don't say, here is a bag. There you go. They could actually come in to store and pick what bag they would like.
Wow.
So that's like bonus upon a bonus.
Definitely. Yeah. And viewers, make sure you stay with us tonight, because I know that CL and Contrap has a lot of treats and goodies for you. But you have to listen and you have to watch carefully. Now, you know, I'm always giving you hints. All right. So listen and watch carefully, and you're going to win something really terrific from Sea Island Cotton Shop. Now, for my week, well, I want to know, do you like my new look at my hair? Okay. Now, this was actually created by Robert Ganza, and he is an artistic director of the Bellagio Resort and Casino in Las Vegas. And he was just a wonderful guy. And of course, you all know Pamela Dulour from Strand's hair salon. She always does my hair. But since I was actually in Las Vegas, I took the opportunity because, of course, as you know, DBS was showing the cricket, which everyone really loves on Thursday. So I took the opportunity to go over and have a great time with the Virtuoso Travel Week hoteliers, which actually gives you insider access to luxury travel. And I had a really great week there. And Robert, I met him there, and he said to me, I know who you are. Shock. Shock. You know, in Vegas, that someone, you know, knew who I was. Mm-hmm. And he took me to the salon, and he cut my hair, and he gave me this lovely cut. And he's actually going to be visiting St. Lucia, because I told him so many wonderful things about St. Lucia. So he's going to be coming over. So I'm going to say thank you so much to him for all the guidance and help, which I've been talking to Pamela about. So they kind of exchange some kind of little hints. So Pamela's got some updated Vegas hints to anyone who wants to visit her at her beauty salon, of course, in Rodney Bay. Okay, so that's a little bit about me and what I've done for the last couple of weeks. And I want to know from both my guests tonight, what are you thinking about tonight in terms of what are you hoping that we'll achieve, Vanetta?
Well, I'm thinking we should be able to direct St. Lucians as to how best to dress for certain, well, for all occasions, because a lot of people need that guidance. So I'm thinking, like, after tonight's show, I think whoever is watching can actually have an idea, okay, I will look at myself in the mirror a little bit more before I step out of the house. So I think that is what we're really trying to achieve. That's what I want to achieve, actually.
Okay, we'll review it later on tonight to make sure that we have, we hope that we think we've achieved that.
That's right.
Kashel.
Well, on my part, representing Sea Island, I know our Sea Island ladies and gents are looking out for our show tonight, because we have been promoting it, speaking about it on our Facebook. I'm hoping from that show, persons could come in and actually having a better idea of what they're looking for, how they'd like us to style them, because part of our job at Sea Island is to dress persons, and sometimes even our sales reps need some extra guidance, as you know, how to dress and style persons, not only for the body types, but for the different occasions. So I'm hoping from the public and for us ourselves, for myself, that we could get some guidance as to, you know, what looks good, what's appropriate, what's kind of fits to give a complete look from the hair down to your shoes.
Okay, and also let me let the viewers know that we're not just looking at women, we're going to be looking at the men too, because I'm telling you, as much as we have some nice suave gentlemen, we have some gentlemen, come on guys, you need to get that act together. I don't know how else to tell you that. Okay, because I, you know, they say about the way to a man's heart is through his food. I don't know about that anymore, because men can cook food just as well as women, but I think that, you know, the same way that you want us to dress really nice for you, then we want you to dress nicely for us. So we have something for you as well. Now, let's do our two in a row. Don't think you were going to escape it tonight. Now, Vanetta, tell us one of the most ridiculous things that someone has ever told you.
I've been compared to a number of different people in regards to the way I look. Okay. And I wouldn't want to call it ridiculous, although the person might, don't kill me after the show. But I was told once that I look like Grace Jones. So this particular person, every time he would see me, he's like, Grace Jones, please don't kill me after the show. But I think that's what I would call it ridiculous. It was just really funny because I used to wear my hair really, really, really short back in the day. So maybe that is why that, you know, comparison came. But I think it's...
you don't think Grace Jones is an attractive woman?
I think she's a beautiful woman. But it's like, I have heard, okay, of different people, but Grace Jones was just a shocker to me at that time.
Okay.
I was like, okay, Grace Jones. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. But that's what I think is.
I think it could be as well. You have, you know, the oval.
The facial structure. Some people tell me that.
The chin. Yeah. And she has that similar to you.
And she has some strong features as well. And people tell me, okay, when they do the split screen, they have some. Because in some of my photos in my past modeling career, people say, okay, that there are some photos that actually make gear. We can see that, so,
Okay, all right then, well, I won't say who I think you look like. Okay, now, Kashel, do you believe in horoscopes and why?
To say that, that's one of the most ridiculous questions you could have asked me. I have one Vanessa's question in there. But anyway, horoscopes, I've never really thought too much of them or gone too deep in them. So I can't say that I don't believe in them because I can't judge because I've never really explored horoscopes. Mm-hmm. Some persons do, well, fair game to them. But for myself, I've never really taken on a thought of horoscopes seriously. Mm-hmm. Probably do a bit more research or read it on, I'll probably be like, oh yeah, probably, maybe yes or no. But for now, I'm just mutual when it comes to...
I think that's called a safe answer. Yeah. You're just playing safe.
Yeah.
you know,
but I don't want to just totally disregard it. Not knowing, you know, the full extent of what it's
to
about.
Be respect, because, you know, some people, they live off it. Some people, first thing in the morning, they're opening their magazines or they're on the TV or wherever it is, they get it online and they read their horoscopes and that sets their day for them. You know, they really believe that. Mm-hmm. But I have to say, there is one book that I read. It's called Black Sun Signs. Mm-hmm. And that book was just, when I read it, I could identify my friends through them, and I actually tested it. I would read it and think, oh my gosh, that sounds like Jack. And I'd ring Jack and say, Jack, it's your birthday. I said, oh my gosh, that is a brilliant book, Black Sun Signs. So if anyone's like into horoscopes, I would say read that book. And if you're not into horoscopes and you're like, not sure, read that book and it will change your opinion on that.
So I'm guessing you believe in horoscopes then?
I think that I believe in some of it because I'm Aquarian, and some of the things they say about Aquarian, it's just that is not me at all. Yeah. And some of it, that is me. You know? But you could say that for any sign, I think, unless you have a true believer who can sit down and tell me something differently, you know, and try to convince me, like Stephen Dante sat on this very chair, tried to convince me about love and the definitions of love and so on and so forth. And we're still at loggerheads. I saw him this week and we're still at loggerheads of that. But, you know, each to his own, with all due respect. Okay, so our painting on set this week is Cherry Picker. The artist is Mozera Henry, and it's available at the Inner Gallery, St. Lucia's premier art and picture framing gallery. It's actually, of course, along the Bois d'Orange Highway. And incidentally, there's office space available there if you're looking. And that is where the Delor Factor Live office is located. So if you win something, that's where you go to collect your giveaway. Of course, you can come to DBS, but you're quite welcome to come to the office. Okay, so I know you're sitting there and you're waiting for your giveaways, and this is the time. So, name Delor Factor Live's water sponsor, and how many consecutive years did they sign the agreement for carrying the national standard mark for quality? So, name Delor Factor Live's water sponsor, and how many consecutive years did they sign the agreement for carrying the national standard mark for quality? I always give you hints, all right? That's quite easy. Research the rest. Now, giveaway number two. Name Delor Factor Live's ice cream sponsor and tell us how long they've been in existence. So, name Delor Factor Live's ice cream sponsor and tell us how long they've been in existence. Now, winners will receive products from each sponsor. And Kashel has something really special to give away from Sea Island Cotton Shop. So, can you tell our viewers what it is?
Yeah, well, at Sea Island Cotton Shop, we like to give stuff away, especially our Delor Factor. Mm-hmm. During the week, we have been promoting the show on our Facebook page, and we've put up three flyers. What we'd like you to do is go to our Facebook page and pull off the codes from these flyers. If you just go all the way to the bottom of the flyers themselves, the codes are there. And the first two persons to text in with the three codes, they could win two shopping vouchers from Sea Island Cotton Shop. And that's just the first set of giveaways from us.
Okay, so to win that, As Cashel says, you know how to contact Dolor Factor Live. You have the phone number to text is 487-3327. That's 487-3327. You can call the studio here. You can BB us at 23C0977C. That's 23C0977C. You can go on to the Dolor Factor Live Facebook page and you'll see all the information there. And of course, it'll come up on the screen. But the first person for the Sea Island Cotton Shop giveaway. So,
the first two.
Yeah. That's not fair. Okay, I've got this on the go. I'm in the ready in the break. But when we come back, we're going to show you ways that you should consider to always look good. So don't go away.